Bienvenido a otro video del Colegio Boston. No olvides suscribirte, activar la campanita, darle like y compartir.
Hello, good morning, students. My name is Victor Manuel. I'm a teacher here at Colegio Boston. Today, we're on the week of May, so I'm going to be giving you some topics, some of grammar and some of vocabulary to show you how to do some of the activities. This is going to help you with the activities of this week of May. Please pay attention. If you have any questions, remember that you can ask me any question that you have in the different sessions that we have as a teacher. Now, in this case, also remember that some of the pages of your book, you are going to have them in your house because you have your book. But in the case that you do not have your book, don't worry. The pages of the book are also in the web link of colegioboston.edu.mx. So there is no problem for you. You can still do the activities in your house, even if you don't have your book. This is very important. Please stay at home. Do not go outside unless it is totally necessary. In this case, if you have to go for groceries, go. But not going to the park, not going to plazas, to malls, not going anywhere where it's outside your house for the need of food and groceries. Now, to start with, we're going to go with the grammar usage of wish. In this case, wish is something very important. It's something that we desire, something that we want, but that in this moment, it is not possible to have it. Now, in this case, let me ask you guys, what do you wish for? What is it that you require? What is it that you need? What is it that you really desire for you to have, to be in this place, in this moment, in this time? I have in here some examples. Let me see if my examples are the same as with you, with what you really wish for. Let's see. The first one could be video games. Do you wish you had more video games? Probably, yes. I mean, you're a teenager. Probably you're into video games. Not all of you. I mean, some of you are into books, into science, into math. But some of you, I know that you're going to be into video games. What about money? Do you wish you had more money? Well, in this case, the money is the one that your parents make, but probably you are having your own business. Maybe you are selling some of the toys that you have. Maybe you are buying and selling some goods. I don't know. But money, in this case, is a very important issue that all of us, we wish we had more. Now, family time. Well, actually, this is like great news. In these moments, we're having a lot of family time. And actually, I mean, it is bad that we are living a pandemic, but don't worry, guys, because in this case, we have more family reunion. This is the perfect time for you to rejoin, to reconnect with your family, to be with the ones that you love. In this case, people normally say, I wish I had more free time with my family because I don't have enough time. I mean, I have school, I have the extra activities, I have to go with my friends, I have to visit other people. But being with the family is something that we really wish for, but that sometimes we do not have. And we really wanted that, but it's not possible. Guess what? In this moment, it's possible. So please be with your family. Be with your mom, with your dad, with your brother, with your sister, whichever you have. As long as you have a really good time, this is a good time for you to get to know each other. Probably you can ask your parents to tell you some of the stories of their infancy. That could be a really good idea. I mean, this is a really good time for you to have family time. Now, toys. I mean, stuffed toys we have in this case. But not only stuffed toys, you can have all the type of toys that you want. You can have like cars, you can have like tricycles, bicycles, I don't know. Things that you really desire, things that you really want. I know that you're teenagers and you say, toys probably is not my thing. But guess what? There are a lot of things that you can also have. I mean, I have a nephew who really likes to have Funkos. For example, those are toys that he wish he had more. I mean, he has the Avengers collection and he really likes them. So he wish he had more to have like the complete edition, special edition, if any. Now, finally, gadgets. Some of you, like I told you, you wish for more. In this case, you could wish, I don't know, for headphones, earphones, I don't know, maybe from a laptop, from another video game, a camera. We can have microphones. We can have recorders. I mean, it's vast, the things that you can have as gadgets. maybe you wish you had like a bigger screen computer or bigger screen television. I mean, those are some of the things that people want, that people wish, that people desire to. Today, we're going to be talking about how to make a sentence, how to structure a sentence using wish. So please be prepared for that. Let's continue. Now, first of all, we need to start with the definition. What is wish? How do you use wish? What is wish for? What do you think? Let's try to see. We have, we use the verb wish to talk about things which we want, but which are not possible. Okay, so let's try to think about this. Something that we want, but it's not possible. Maybe at this moment, it is not possible. Maybe in the future will be possible, but in the present time, it's not something that you have. Like I was explaining you, family time is actually something that people wish for, and they have it in this moment. They're having it. And I hope that you are really enjoying with your family. I hope that you are really having a great time with your family. That would be awesome. I really recommend you to do that. Now, continuing with, we have grammar types of wishes, because you know, we have three different types of wishes. We have wish plus past verb in the simple form, okay, no modification. We have wish plus would, and finally, we have wish plus could. In a few moments, we're going to be revising all of these three different types of grammar of wishes, and we're going to check that they refer to similar but not identical situations. Okay, so let's check them out, shall we? It says, how to express wishes in English. We use wish to express that we regret something or we would like something to be different than the way it is. Okay, so we have a regret. We feel bad that something is not the way it should be in this moment, but it could be different in this moment. For example, we have wish plus past simple when we want a situation in the present or future to be different. For example, I wish I ate more vegetables, but I don't. I mean, in the present time, I don't do it. Well, actually, you should be doing it. I think that in this moment, your mom or your dad, or even you are helping prepare the meals, like the breakfast, lunch, dinner. And I think that this is a very good opportunity for you to get to know what vegetables taste like. They're delicious. I really recommend you to eat vegetables. And what's more, it's good for your health. So let's continue. We have wish plus past. We have a formula. Remember, the formula is the structure, how a sentence is done. How a sentence is structured. Let's see, what's the formula for wish plus past? We have, it says in here, subject plus wish plus object plus the verb in simple past plus the complement, okay? We're going to be checking part by part which are the different elements of our sentence in a wish plus past sentence, shall we? Let's see. We have that the subject, for example, could be I. We have the word wish, we have the object, I, then again. We have had, which is the verb in the simple past, and we have the complement. For example, I wish I had more free time to be with my family. This is what I was explaining to you before. You wish you had more free time to be with your family? Well, guess what? In this moment, that is something possible, but in the past, it was not. And probably in the future, after we pass this pandemic, you are really going to miss having all this time spent with your family. And this is something that you will wish for, okay? So maybe in the future, let's say June, July, when all of this pandemic is over, you're going to be like, I wish I had more free time to be with my family like I had in the past, okay? In this moment, you are having it, so please enjoy it. Enjoy the time that you are having with your family. It's a really good opportunity for you to be with them. Now to check some of the other examples. We have, I wish I went out more to the parks. I gotta tell you, in these moments, that is not possible. I mean, if you have a big house with a park, well, then it's possible. You can go to your backyard, to the park that you have behind your house. But if you are living in a small house or maybe in a condominium or like a building, it is not possible for you to go to the parks. So you wish you went out more to the parks, something that in this moment it is not possible to do it. Now, I wish I ate more red meat. This is also something very delicious. Like I was telling you, vegetables are really delicious, but also eating red meat, poof, prime quality. I really love red meat, and I recommend you, just please be careful, do not eat too much red meat, because too much of something, remember, it's always bad. Too much of money, too much of drinks, too much of beverages, too much of red meat, even too much water is not healthy. So please be balanced on the way that you are eating. We have one more. It says, I wish I played better in video games. Like I was explaining you, you're teenagers. I know that you play video games. I know that not all of you. Some of you also like to read, I know. But in the case of you who are gamers, I know that you wish you played better in video games. Every day, every month, every year, they're releasing new video games and people want to be better in those video games. Even there are some streamers. People might say, oh, I'm going to drop out of school and I'm going to become a streamer. I'm going to be the best video game player and I'm going to get paid by that. I really don't recommend you that. I mean, it's not that it's something bad, but what I would recommend you to do is to focus, to mentalize that you need to be the best in the school. That way you are going to succeed in life. And maybe after you have finished with school, you can play video games, and then you will wish you will be playing better in video games. For the moment, some people wish they played better in video games. Okay, let's continue. I wish I got better grades at school. Actually, this is what I was telling you. Please pay attention to that. Be better at school. Do not always focus on having fun. You also need to focus on studying. For those of you who are watching this video, congratulations, guys. For those of you who have friends who haven't watched this video, please tell them, hey, call them, maybe by a cell phone, WhatsApp, Messenger. Hey, we're having a wonderful, amazing, and extraordinary video about the grammar that we need to have for the exercises of this week. We have teacher Victor is explaining which, the three different forms on how to use which. So please, let your friends know that they have this video for them to check it out. This is actually something really good. Let's continue. We have how to express wishes in English. It's an explanation. We use wish to express that we regret something or we would like something to be different than the way it is. Teacher, that is the same yes and no. Because in this case, we have wish. Wish plus would. It says, we want something to happen. We want someone to start doing something. We want someone to stop doing something which annoys us, which bothers us, which is like terrible for us. These are three different ways that we can use wish plus would. Okay, so now you see there is a difference. It's not exactly the same. They express different ideas. They might have like the same formula, but they express different ideas. It says an example, I wish the lesson would end. Probably when you're doing a lot of homework, you wish the lesson would end. And actually that is good. I mean, everybody would wish that. But first we need to pay attention and we need to do our chores. The next one, I wish you'd listen to me. If you see we have a contraction of you'd. You'd is a contraction of you would. You would listen to me. This is something that as teachers and probably as parents, we tell to our children. I wish you would listen to me. You don't pay attention. You hear from here, but it goes out from here. So I need you to please pay attention, to listen, to please open up your ideas to what I'm telling you. Now, it says, I wish you wouldn't borrow my clothes. Okay? Probably for those of you who have brothers or sisters, you know the feeling. So in some cases, your brother or your sister, they take your clothes, you know? You are in the morning, you are getting dressed up, and when you see your brother or your sister, he or she has the same t-shirt that you had in your closet, or maybe the same pants, or the same dress, or the same skirt, and you're like, hey, what's going on? Please, don't take my clothes. You know, I always wish you wouldn't borrow my clothes, but you always do. That's something that really annoys me. Okay? Now, to continue with, we have wish plus would or could and bare infinitive. Bare infinitive is like the verb in the simple form, no modification. Okay? In this case, we're going to make a comparative on how is the difference of wish plus would and wish plus could, like I was explaining to you. It might seem that it's the same, but it is not. They have very slight differences, but they are like major and huge differences when you are writing. Please, when you're doing your grammar exercises from the book, pay attention to this video. It's going to help you a lot, okay? It says, ability or possibility in the present or near future. Example given, I wish I could get in touch with Tom. I wish I could find a better job. This is something about an ability or possibility that in this moment is not possible for you to have, but that you want for the future or the near future, probably from the present too. Now, it says note, very important. The structure wish plus would is used with different subjects. Example given, I wish I could find a better job. Not, I wish I would find a better job. Okay? Now, I wish she would find a better job. That is actually correct. So, if you please check it out, this part, it says that when you are using could, you can repeat the same subject as the object. I wish I could. I wish I. So I and I are the same subject and object of the sentence. But when you are using would, it is different. You need to use another object, another person. That's why it says, I wish she would find a better job. Okay, so we need to use my desire for another person, not for me, at least not when I'm using would. Now, the last part, it says wish plus would. Complain about the present or a desire for a change when you don't like something that is happening in the present, but you want it to be different in the future. Example given. I wish she would stop asking me silly questions. You know, silly questions is like absurd questions. It's not actually a bad question, but it's actually something that is not really necessary. I don't know, probably example when we are in a class and I'm telling you, okay, today we're going to be talking about wish in the three different types. And you're like, teacher, I have a question. Yes, please tell me, what is your question? Teacher, why is the sky blue? And I'm like, is that something that is related to the class? No, teacher, but I want to know. Probably the sky is blue because it's a reflection of the sunlight towards the water, and that's why you check and you see that it's... But that is not something that has to do with the class, so please focus, you know? I wish she would stop asking me silly questions, absurd questions, questions that are not related to the topic that we are checking. Okay, the next one we have wish plus would and wish plus could to talk about wishes for the future. We're going to check the formula. The formula we have subject, wish, object, would, verb in simple form, and the complement. We have, it says that the first one is the subject I, then we have wish, then we have object, we have in this case she. We have would, the verb in the simple form speak, and the complement to me in class. This is something that we would like to happen. I wish she would speak to me in class. She doesn't. I really want it, but she doesn't do it. I don't know why. The next one we have, subject plus wish, object, could, verb in simple form, and the complement. The subject we have I, the wish we have in this case, object, I could go to the cinema with my family. So if you notice, we have two different forms. We have that when you are using would, we have I, and then you have she. But when you are using could, we have I, and then you are using I is the same subject as the same object. Okay, so that is a slight but major difference. We have wish plus would, different object and subject. Wish plus could, same subject as the same object. Something important. Now, to finish with today's lesson, today's class, we're going to talk about vocabulary for home and garden. This is for one of the activities that you have on your book. Okay, this is vocabulary that probably you do not know, but that is something that you really want to know. We have different objects. The first one is spade. Okay, this is for you to use it in the garden. The next one, do you know the name? Garden fork. The next one, this is a hose. What about this one? Do you know it? Sprinkler. This one? No, no ideas? Lawn mower. What about this one? They look like scissors, right? You say scissors, I know it, but actually they are not called scissors. I mean, the ones that are for garden, at least they're not scissors, they're clippers, okay? The next one, it looks like a big house. No, it's not. It's a compost bin. What about this one? Ah, this one, you know it. I mean, in here, in all the different houses here in Cancun, you have it. What's it called? Exactly, a hammock. Then we have, obviously, one of the other items that is in every Cancun house, air conditioner. And the last one, well, just two more. We have, obviously, fan, something that is also in our houses. And we have rake. This is for you to use it similar to a broom, but in the garden, okay? Maybe for the leaves that fall from the trees. Now, thank you very much, students, for having today paying attention in this class. I really hope that you are doing all your homework. Please, if you are not doing your homework, please do it. Remember, these videos are for you to help you with some of the exercises that you have on your book. The other page of the homework is for you to make a reading and comprehension, okay? But that is something that that you can do it in your house. You just need to please pay attention to the context that you are having, and from there, you are going to get all the answers. Please do it. Thank you very much for having this class. Thank you, and have a wonderful day. Goodbye.